In the previous videos, we have learned that the languages recognized by our Turing machine are called Turing-recognizable languages. We have also discussed how our Turing machine, when given an input, can either accept it, reject it, or enter an infinite loop without reaching a decision. This behavior allows us to classify Turing-recognizable languages into two broad categories, decidable and undecidable languages. Decidable languages are those for which our Turing machine always halts with a specific output, such as accept yes or reject no, on every possible input. In other words, the machine never enters an infinite loop for any input. On the other hand, undecidable languages are those for which no Turing machine can guarantee a halt with a decision for every possible input. This means for some inputs, the Turing machine loops forever without ever accepting or rejecting. The Turing machines we have discussed so far in the previous videos are all designed for decidable languages. To understand undecidable languages, let's explore a classical and well-known decision problem called the halting problem. Let's start with the problem definition. The halting problem asks whether there exists a Turing machine H that can decide for every possible Turing machine M and input string W whether M will eventually halt, that is stop running, when executed on input W, or whether it will run forever in an infinite loop. Let's prove by contradiction that the halting problem is undecidable. Let's assume the opposite, that there exists a magical Turing machine H. H takes as input a description of a Turing machine M and input string W. In case M halts on the input W, H outputs yes. Otherwise, when M goes into an infinite loop, H outputs no. Now, let's use H to create another Turing machine D. Like H, D also takes two inputs, the description of Turing machine M and input string W. However, instead of processing any arbitrary input W, D is specifically designed to take M's own description. Here is the twist. If H determines that M halts on the input, D enters an infinite loop. Conversely, if H determines that M loops forever, D immediately halts. This is where the contradiction arises. What happens if we feed D its own description as input? Think about it. If H says D halts, then D loops forever. Therefore, H answer was incorrect. Similarly, if H says D loops forever, then D halts, once again proving that H is not giving us the correct answer. This logical paradox means that our assumption about H existence must be false. Therefore, no program can perfectly determine whether another program will halt in every case. This is why the halting problem is undecidable. This ends our proof. That is it for this video. If you found it helpful, please support the channel. Your support is critical for its survival. See you soon. Bye.